Hi, my name is Thaddea Graham and I play Vivian. So Vivian is a 20-something on the run from her family. She came out as gay and her family were fine with it, but they kind of said, just don't tell anybody else. And she thought, I'm not doing that. Maxed out her dad's credit card and made her way onto the cruise ship. And she's now one of the new crew. And they call them bloobs because they wear blue t-shirts. Sorry, someone's looking at me. And she is extremely headstrong and very confident and very unapologetically herself, which was such a luxury to play because I think you learn a lot from someone like that. And what drew me towards her, I think it was that bravery and that kind of, but also the compassion that she has. She's a bit of a lone wolf, but she's one of those people who, if she lets you into her heart, you're there forever. And I think that's what she finds with Jamie. And I think that is such a gorgeous relationship to see on screen. A guy and a girl who have no hint of romance between the two of them. And it's not about, will they sleep together or will they not? That's kind of squashed in episode one. And they then just grow together. And I think they're soulmates. And I think that's a really beautiful thing to see. And we need more of that. So the guy who plays Jamie is a little shit called Oscar Kennedy, who I utterly adore. Oh, the party started. He is phenomenal and he is so sensitive and caring as an actor and as a person. I mean, it's really hard not to fall in love with him. So it's an utter joy to work alongside him every single day. And I couldn't have done it without him. I feel like one of the best things that has come out of this show personally is a group of people who I feel so comfortable and safe with, and I think that's a very rare thing. When Vivian meets Jamie, he's creeping around asking weird questions from other crew members, and she thinks it's a bit odd and corners him and kind of confronts him, and he admits that his sister went missing and he was told by the company that she had jumped overboard, but he doesn't think that's true. So he's here to figure out what really happened. And Vivian looks at him and goes, you're really, really bad at this. You need help. I will do that. And so they go on this, it's not an adventure. I'd say it's a journey. And they make some quite gruesome, terrifying discoveries about people in power. And it gets a bit gory. Horror and comedy, like so many things, art imitates life and life imitates art. And you can't have the highs without the lows. And I think what is really beautiful about this marriage is that you have awfully scary moments and then you're laughing in the next. And I think the up and down, it just keeps you constantly on the edge of your seat. And it's so much fun to create that. And also it means that you don't get too comfortable and that it doesn't get too heavy or too light. But one of my favorite things about this show, I think tonally, is that it also has a lot of heart. The characters feel really real and very nuanced and grounded, and the connection between people, I think you see that grow over the series, and I think that they all go through a very intense shared experience, and when you have that, it connects you in a very deep way, and I think it's really lovely to watch it play out, and I hope people enjoy it. It sounds so cheesy, but just getting to go to work every day with like some of my best friends, I didn't know any of them before. But we all kind of got on so well, which is a credit to Louise Kiley, our casting director, and Chris, our director, and Nimi, our exec, who kind of put us all together. And I think that was, every day was fun, even the hard ones, because it does get, every job gets hard and it's tiring work, but our crew were phenomenal and the set pieces were amazing to walk onto because we built a lot of the sets, a lot of the interior. We weren't on a real cruise ship. But the art department have done an incredible job there, and the design as well. But also, I think shooting in Northern Ireland for me, shooting in places that I used to go as a kid and that I used to walk around before I even thought that this was a job or that you could do this, was really surreal and very, very special. So those are some of my fondest memories, and getting to share it with such a brilliant group of people. I think you should tune in and watch Rec on BBC Three or iPlayer, wherever you are in the world, because it's dead good quack.